In this video, we're going to discuss the funnel and pyramid chart custom visual from xViz. We're actually going to look at some website sales data to understand our sales pipeline. To get started, I'm going to take my action field, put it in the axis, and my total in the values. We can even throw in tooltip measures, for example, percent of visits and percent lost. So very quickly, we have a nice funnel that is showing us our sales pipeline data. For example, we can see that a lot of people are visiting the website, but fewer of these people are actually navigating to a product page, and fewer are adding an item to a cart, and finally, the fewest amount of people are actually performing a transaction. We even have these tooltips that are going to show us how many were lost moving from the previous category or the percentage of visits that made it to that point. We can show this as a pyramid chart as well in the formatting options. If we go to chart options, we can change our chart type to pyramid and view that as a pyramid, or changing it back to funnel. We can set a chart width of, let's say, 60 to make that a little bit skinnier. We can also switch the orientation up or down. So if we want to show that as a down funnel, we can show it that way, or back to vertical. And then finally, we can show it in 3D mode. So if we check that on, we also have options to rotate by the x-axis, y-axis, or add depth to our visualization. I'm gonna turn it back to a pyramid chart and change that y rotation to negative 10 to give us an idea of the 3D aspect of this visualization. Turning off the 3D mode and going back to a funnel chart, we can also set some data labels to show on our visualization. For example, if I turn that on, we can see some data labels that pop outside, and we have a lot of formatting options here as well. For example, we can show our overlapping labels in case there are multiple categories. We have the option to show all of our detail labels or select between just the category, data value, or any combination of those. I choose the all detail labels. We can position each of the category labels on the inside or the data value labels on the inside or outside. The percent of total position on the inside or outside as well. So you have full customization of where you want to place your data labels. We can even change the font color or font size if we so choose. And finally, we have some other formatting options to show the background in case you want to pop out or change that background color or transparency. This is already looking good. So next, I'm going to show you how we can sort this funnel in case we want to show it in a particular order. For example, if I want to sort by which category is providing the most loss from the previous category, I can throw in my percent lost into the sort by field, and we can see that we have now sorted based on add to cart, showing us that that is our category that is providing that largest loss between the pipeline. We can also conditionally format this chart in case we really want to see which categories are providing that loss. For example, if I click on this pencil icon, we can apply conditional formatting rules. If I click plus, we can set up a red rule to show us where loss is, say, over 40% from that pipeline. We can format by rule based on our total field. Actually, I'm going to base that off of percent lost. And if I set this to be greater than or equal to 0.4 and click save, we will now see that one of these categories will turn red because that is providing a loss of over 40%. We can also create another rule to color the better categories as green. So I'm going to change the coloring here to this rule, select a nice green color, click save. And we're basing it off that percent lost category as well, where it's less than 0.4. We'll click save. And now all of the other categories will be conditionally formatted to show as green because they're not providing too much loss in our pipeline. So if we go back to report, we'll now see our conditional formatting show up. And then finally, once we have this chart looking the way we want, we can export all of the data behind this visual. To do that, we go to the formatting pane and scroll down until you see summary table. Turn that on. I'm also going to make sure advanced table options is on as well. That's going to open up this table icon, which we can open up. And then we see all of the columns that make up this visual. We can move these around if we want to, or filter down to a specific action or total. We even have the ability to create a pivot table on the fly and apply filters directly to this pivot table. For example, if I only want to show values that are greater than 1,000, we'll see that one of my categories has been filtered out. And once we have this looking like we want, we can export this to Excel with this button here in the top right. And with that, that is the funnel and pyramid chart from xViz. I definitely recommend checking this out in case you have some pipeline related data or just want to visualize how your data is changing between the categories.